Coming up next, boys high school basketball on your sports leader in Lorain, WLCS TV 20.
Good evening, Jay Ferguson, Bob Braskich here with you. Varsity boys basketball is the subject. Two very good teams tonight, Bob. The Medina Bees, 11-3 on the year, and the Lorain Titans, 9-2 on the season. And a contrast in styles once again for the Titans, as it's, you know, speed and quickness and having to speed up the game versus the Bees, who want to play you in the half court. And why is that, Bob?
Well, because they have size and 7 feet one, John Teske. And you said Michigan State recruit?
Michigan recruit.
Michigan recruit, I'm sorry.
Yep.
And that's a problem. I mean, you've got to keep them off the boards, and you've got to try to prevent the ball from going inside to them. The other thing that bothers me about tonight's game, Jay, is last year when we did this same game,
right,
if you'll recall, we had a tough time pressing them. So it's not like, and they're very well organized, it's not like we're going to get a bunch of scores or a flurry of scores with our full court pressure.
Yeah, I remember it well, Bob. I was on the bench for that one as part of the Medina coaching staff. And I know a lot of these players, and exactly what you're saying. I expect Medina to come out and be very organized. However, common opponent. Both teams have lost to St. Ed's. And St. Ed's pressed Medina very effectively in the first half at Baldwin-Wallace for the shootout. So, you know, the second half they solved it a little bit, to the point where St. Ed's backed off as Medina made a run in that game before losing by 15 or 16, but they showed vulnerability to the pressure, and specifically to on-the-ball pressure.
Interesting.
And Coach Rossitano, the last thing he said to me as I came up, if we can't speed him up, we're going to be in trouble. They're going to be in trouble because you put 7 foot one on the block and throw him the ball, and Lorain doesn't have anybody to match up with that. Anthony Smothers is 6'7", but if you do the math, he's given away 6 inches to John Teske.
But and Jay, what they did last year was they used Teske to relieve pressure very effectively.
Yeah, he's going to Michigan not only because he's 7'1", but for his size, he's very skilled. He'll step out and shoot the three almost to a fault because Medina is toughest when he's on the block.
Wow.
Both teams last year coming off of district championships last year. And I look for this one to be exciting right down to the wire if Lorain can speed up Medina.
I can't wait.
Yep, looking forward to it. We'll be back with the opening tip right after this timeout.
My grandfather served in World War II. Spending time with him were the best memories of my life. I became a physician at VA because of my grandfather, so I can help others like him. I can't imagine working with better doctors or a more dedicated staff. I'm fulfilling my life's mission with the help of my team and thanks to these veterans. I'm proud to be a doctor at VA and proud to honor my grandfather every day. Search VA Careers to find out more.
Jay Ferguson back here at Lorain High School. The introduction to the players are done, and we're about set for basketball. For Medina, number one, Benny Geschke, number 12, Jackson Sartain on the perimeter. On the wings, 22, Luke Schaefer, 32, Jimmy Clark, and 7'1" in the middle, number 33, John Teske. For Lorain in the middle, it's number 20, Anthony Smothers at 6'7". He'll be giving away a half a foot.
No.
33, Nas Bohannon down there with him. And on the perimeter for Lorain, it's 0, Kevin Davis, 1, Dobby Andrews, and 10, Jamar Ross. The players are all set. The officials ready to toss it up, and we've got basketball. Teske controls the tip to Geschke. Benny Geschke's been a varsity player now for 3 years, the junior. Torch Teske, a four-year starter. Luke Schaefer takes a 19-footer and hits the first shot of the game, 2-0. Medina drops back, looks like a zone.
Yep.
Nas Bohannon
nice
finds
cut.
A hole. He's got two. And that's what they've got to do. They've got to challenge that hole in the middle of the zone if Medina wants to play it. Against pressure, Medina looks to get it through. Andrews has got Geschke. This is the key matchup. Geschke shoots it behind the screen.
Went behind the screen and he stroked it.
Knocked down a three, and it's 5-2. And talking to Benny before the game, as I said, I've coached a lot of these kids, and when I saw him against St. Ed's, his dad said to me he's having a little head problem now. Smothers trying to bring Teske away. Jackson Sartain rebounds the ball against Ross. Geschke again brings it to the middle. Schaefer on the weave around behind Teske. Down low, Teske into the middle, jump hook, knocks it in. He's got that either way, but he definitely favors the right hand. 7-2 Bees. Kevin Davis on the penetration, blocked by Geschke, and he takes it away. Wow.
Geschke, Jays, looks to me very stable up top.
Well,
at the point.
He's going to play basketball in college. I just don't know what level. This is the best shooter, Jackson Sartain. And he knocks down a three. It's 10-2, Medina. And just what Coach Rossitano didn't want to happen was they haven't sped him up yet. This is a man-to-man now, Bohannon. Jamar Ross. Davi Andrews. 10 stitches in his hand. We watched him play over the weekend, and he was effective. Bohannon with the jump.
Oh, my.
Nas with all four of the Lorain points, 10-4.
Well, they're going to inbound it to Teske.
And they like, well, he's 7-1. He can look over it. And they get it over to Geschke and then get out of the way. Benny's brother was a second-team All-Ohio a couple years ago, playing currently in Goshen, Indiana. And take a minute to wish him well as he had knee surgery.
Wow.
Benny
Geschke.
Time
out, John.
Yep. Benny Geschke hits his second three. 3 of 3 behind the line for Medina to start the game.
Jay, usually you can go behind screens comfortably at the high school level. And, we've seen twice here tonight where we've gone behind the screen and they've backed off and stroked it.
And both of those guys can shoot the ball rather effectively.
Wow. Very impressive.
Well, but, what Coach Rossitano said early on, as I talked to him before the game, we've got to speed him up. Medina's been very comfortable with the basketball. And part of that's because Lorain hasn't scored.
Right, exactly.
You got to score the ball to be able to press. Right now it's 13-4, and the Titans are unable to get into their pressure. They'll inbound the ball right in front of the Lorain bench. 5:18 to go. Nas Bohannon will toss it into Kevin Davis. Medina stays with the zone. Do they? Maybe
yes,
not.
Yes, they do.
Yes, they do. Kevin Davis looks to penetrate. Smothers is out there trying to help him. Skips it over to Davi Andrews.
On.
Three ball.
Yes. Up. Big basket.
Lorain hits one. 13-7. That was good offense. Trap there. They get it over to Schaefer, who gets it ahead to Jimmy Clark.
Look out.
Sartain. Good run at him, but he takes one dribble and nails it.
Wow.
Jackson Sartain with six. It's 16-7. Medina's 4 of 4 behind the line. Andrews with an unforced error over and back. Jaleel Little in for Jamar Ross.
Now, Jay, this Medina team very well. You can't expect them to continue
Nobody shoots
it
like
this.
That.
But But
those are the two guys you would say they're both good three-point
shooters.
In fact, Jackson Sartain is an outstanding shooter from everywhere. John Teske at the high post, back cut intended for Luke Schaefer, and he didn't get free and out of bounds to Lorain. Kevin Davis will bring it ahead. Lorain in the man-to-man. Jaleel Little.
Nice.
With the left. And it's 16-9.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Luke Schaefer. Andrew stops him. Little right there is that time as Sartain caught the ball. Davis and Geschke. John Teske relieves the pressure. That time Davis gets under it and on the pick and roll, Teske rolls, gets the basket, and there's a foul.
It's going to be on Nas.
On Nas.
Yeah.
You, Shane Smith, number three, into the ball game for Davis. You just don't realize how long he is.
Yeah, 7-1, and you said that's 7-1 in stocking feet.
Misses the foul shot, and Little comes away with it. Down the lane with the left, off the glass, no. Tipped up by Bohannon, no. Nas, another one. That was Smothers, and he tried to get it to Nas, 18-9. And Medina will take it out.
You know, and Jay, he gets up and down the floor okay.
Colin Chomsky, number 20, into the ballgame. Sophomore guard for the Bees. Well, he's just filled out a little bit every year. He was 6'9", and you could x-ray him with a flashlight his freshman year. Chomsky right off the bench throws three, gets none. Andrews going to try and push. Jaleel Little and Shane Smith. Nas, step back, elbow jumper, no. Nice check out right there by the big fella.
Yeah.
And Benny Geschke will bring it up. 18-9, 3:20 to go. A lot of points. But when you're 4-4 behind the line, that happens, doesn't it? Geschke again, sights it, shoots it, missed that one. Good check out by Nas, and he's going to lead the break. 3-on-3, kicks it back to Little. You know, you think you have an advantage, and you look up, and it's 7-1 in front of you. Davi. Knocked away by Teschke and out of bounds.
Jay, you know, one of the things you'd like to do is be able to beat them down the floor, but they recover so well defensively. Difficult.
Yeah. Deshaun Brooks into the ballgame for Lorain. He gets the entry pass and back to Little and then back out. Andrews might have got away with one. Nas over to Shane Smith. Brooks, Davi. With Luke Schaefer, backs it off, kicks it to Brooks, who throws three. Got it.
Yeah, big basket.
Told you before the game.
You did, Jay. You told me.
He was the guy we had to get points from.
You told me.
He can shoot it. Oh, winged past Smith and Chomsky out of bounds.
Timeout, Medina. Well, you just can't make an entry pass from there, Jay. I mean, you got to shorten that up.
As I told you in the JV game, which is aired at a different time, Medina likes to stretch the floor to the corners in transition. So sometimes that happens to them as they don't get the good angle to make that entry pass. Okay, now, has Lorain weathered the storm? What do you think?
I don't know. I think we have. We're down by 6. You'd say, well, geez, you shouldn't feel very well, but I think we've weathered the storm a little bit here. What bothers me is we're not going to get anything this game with our full court pressure, Jay. They're too well organized. They use Teschke to relieve pressure. Yeah, I mean, they reverse the ball or get it to the middle and bring it very patiently. We're not going to score that way. I was hoping we'd be able to beat them back in transition, but they recovered so well.
Teschke to the bench, number 23, Jimmy Dahl in, but Lorain wings it into the bleachers. So Medina goes small. Jimmy Dawes about 6'4", number 23. He's a football player. He'll be a Division I player at the end of next year. Geschke brings it ahead against Jaleel Little. Lob pass to no one. Chomsky picks it up, and Daw drives. Jimmy Daw lays it off the glass over to Sean Brooks. Nice move by Daw. He's got two. Andrews into the lane, splits the double, and he scores.
Great job, Davier.
Davi with five, 20-14. Speeded him up that time. Back to Daw, over to Schaefer. Down in the corner, there's Jackson Sartain. Got it.
Wow.
Sartain's taken three shots and made three threes. He's the difference at 23-14. When you dedicate two to the ball, you better slow it down, and that's what's happening to Lorain is they're just stretching that corner. Andrews left hands it up and in. Nice finish by Davi. Luke
two
Schaefer.
On one.
Tipped up and in by Colin Chomsky.
So many stick back opportunities in transition in high school.
25-16. Andrews penetrates against Jackson Sartain, and then Nas misses everything. And Medina comes out with the rebound. Chomsky with Brooks on his hip lays it up with the left and in. The sophomore, Colin Chomsky off the bench with four. Bohannon in the middle, lays it up short, rebounds it, gets whacked, and Doesn't get a break. Niles will go to the line for two. Foul was on 23, Daw.
Now, Jay, you talked about, the need for Lorain High to speed up the game, but Medina seems very comfortable at that pace, to me.
Well.
Because I've been very impressed with their point guard play, and then, with the sophomore coming off the bench. I mean, he can handle it, too.
Teske returns, as does Davis. They get bigger, we get smaller. Well, the big thing, Bob, is that, they're going to miss.
I know, but what I'm thinking is I know what conference they play in, and I think that might make them better at playing at a high rate of speed.
I'm certain it does. I'm certain that it does. Jimmy Daw inbounds to Colin Sumsky. This is the 1-2-2 look. But there's the pressure release.
45 seconds left.
Jackson Sartain gets it back out to Geschke. He, against Kevin Davis, relieves pressure to John Teske. And they go into their little delay game. There's
nice
the back cut. And Jackson Sartain gets a freebie.
Wow.
11, 29-18 Medina. I'll guarantee they haven't scored 29 points in a quarter.
Well, multiply that by four, and it's almost, 130?
116.
You're the math guy.
Titans will play for one. Davis against the zone. They maybe want to get going here. Double screen for Kevin. Down the lane, pull
get
up
in.
15. Back rim, no. Davis runs it down. I think he double dribbled with it, but lost it, and Teske picks it up, and that'll be the quarter. Wow.
Wow is right.
After one, Medina 29, Lorain 18. Back with more after this timeout.
Can I go to the sleepover?
Lucy, I want you to promise me something. If there's any drinking, I want you to say, no thanks, not my thing.
Mom.
I promise you, your real friends won't care. Deal?
I promise, Mom.
They really do hear you.
Did you pack your toothbrush?
For tips on how to start the talk, visit underagedrinking.samhsa.gov. A public service message from the Substance Abuse and Mental Health Services Administration.
Bohannon inbounds to start the second quarter. Kevin Davis, zero with the ball. Number 10, Jamar Ross, as Coach Rossitano goes back to the starters. 20 Smothers. This is Davis down the lane. Smothers challenges Teske. Rejected, and Davis gets the board and has problems with it. And
rainbow.
I think Teske must have been on the sideline because he definitely bumped it off the ankle of Davis. Daw out, Jimmy Clark in for Medina. So Medina's back to the starters. Ben Geschke, 1, 22, Luke Schaefer, 32, Jim Clark, 33, John Teske, and 12, Jackson Sartain. Bohannon from 18. That's not something we want to end up settling a lot with. Sartain had a rebound, and Geschke will bring it ahead against Davis. Gets it over to Schaefer, down low to the big fella, jump hook in the middle, short, Bohannon aboard. And that's nicely done by Anfernee Smothers. Challenged him straight up. Davis from the corner, short, Smothers a rebound. Throws it up and in.
Oh, yeah.
The big fella, Anfernee Smothers, 29-20, Medina. Schaefer to Teske. Easy to relieve pressure when you throw it up there.
Exactly. They did the same thing last year.
And into the middle, Schaefer got a 3-on-2 down low. Jimmy Clark's got a cheap one. Jimmy Clark with two. It's 31-20. Nicely done by the Bees. Ross, Davis, Davi Andrews against Schaefer.
Nice pass.
Anthony Smothers, bang, with two hands.
Penetrate, draw help.
Nice job. But here's Big Teske leading the break. Against the zone.
7-1 and puts it on the floor.
And you're never going to want him to, but, he can do that. Very flash cut, turn, 10-footer, front rim, back rim, front rim. Bohannon with the board after Medina tip. Nas, Jamar Ross for three.
Come on.
Ooh, big one, but
Davi. Yes, Davi. A lot of stick backs in transition in high school basketball.
Andrews with nine. Timeout, Medina. Which gives me a chance to say, hey, there's never been a better time to enroll in Lorain City Schools. Learn more about all the wonderful opportunities families are enjoying our schools. Go to lorainschools.org. Like the game you're watching tonight? Lorain City Schools is proud of its championship athletics program, including football, basketball, soccer, tennis, cross country, track, golf, bowling, cheerleading, volleyball, baseball, softball, and wrestling. Come join our team. Register today. There's never been a better time to come home to Lorain City Schools. 31-24 Medina, but they were just up 11. Lorain got a couple back on Davi Andrews. Stick four. Back in a Smothers dunk. Now it's four crosses with
hard.
A center fielder.
Yep.
Smothers did a good job. Whistle and yeah, Kevin Davis.
We're going to get Davis for the hole.
Yeah. His first, he grabbed Geschke on the cut and couldn't get loose. There's Benny Geschke against Smothers on a switch, and that's not a matchup Lorain wants because that leaves Teske with a little. Benny gets it across to Luke Schaefer. Luke Schaefer down low. Teske with the left, but he walked. Did he buzz?
I don't know. It was close.
Yeah, I didn't think either. Colin Tumsky, number 20, and 23, Jimmy Daw back for the Bees.
I mean, how adept is he at going?
Well, he went left that time. That was his left hand. He finished with. He's very skilled with both hands. I mean, he's added weight every year as well as growing, too. Kevin Davis gets knocked down, but no call. And the big fella gets another rebound. Benny Geschke down the middle, backs it out, skips it over to Teske, a little bit closer, and he'll look. Geschke with Ross, the count is on. He throws it down to Schaefer, who enters it to Teske, who gets it out to Jimmy Daw. I was going to say, if that one goes in, then we got problems. Teske, two tips, and Andrews controls it. They missed a three, Bob.
Yeah.
Kevin Davis to the hoop, changed his shot.
Oh, Davier again.
Davi with 11. The lead is down to 5, and Chomsky's not going to catch up. There's the speed up.
Brooks in the game for Smothers.
Okay, and Teske comes out. Jimmy Clark in for Medina. So back, Medina's back to the small lineup, which is where Nas has got to get into the office and go to work, I think. Davi Andrews has had some half.
Yes.
And he's got three more.
Oh, yeah.
Andrews knocks it down. It's 31-29. 9-0 run for the Titans. 14 for Davi. Geschke against the double team gets it over to Schaefer. Luke gets it down low to Jimmy Clark, who knocks down the layup. He used the whole rim, but he's got four. 33-29. And for Medina, that was a big hoop. Davis throws three. Missed everything. Clark with a rebound. And they get it over to Geschke. Splits the trap and brings it ahead. He's got two pinned. Pulls up at the foul line. Ooh, that was not a good-looking shot. And back comes Andrews. Davi against Chomsky kicks it out to Day-Day. Penetrates and got fouled. Brooks is going to go to the line. And that was a nice, assertive move he just made.
Mm-hmm.
Number one, Ben Geschke. 6'1 junior gets the foul. 6'4 junior, number 5, Deshaun Brooks at the line. He's got a three ball for his points. That one's up.
All right. Big guy's back in.
Yeah. He's not taking as many breathers as he used to. I mean, his stamina has built up along with his strength.
Well, I know he's rested him twice so far in this half.
Knocks that one down. You know, it's hard to say 7-1 and still growing, but if you take a look at that baby face, you got to believe he still might be. Or the family
there
picture. There's a whistle and a foul. Let's hope this is not on 33.
Oh.
33, Nas Bohannon gets his second. Geschke returns for Schaefer, and you can see where the pressure would bother them without Geschke on the floor. Now Bohannon's got two fouls, and he's guarding Teske, and there's the lob, and this is going down. big John Teske with his third basket for six.
I mean, that's a well-designed play, Jay. It really is.
Shane Smith, Deshaun Brooks, Jamar Ross against Geschke, Jaleel Little. It's a man-to-man, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah.
Bohannon, got to be careful. Throws one with one hand, goes and gets it, loses it on the way up. And Ben Geschke's going to get his second foul. And this is not something that the Medina coaching staff wants to see, because we saw the trouble they had with pressure without him on the floor.
No, Geschke's key.
Now Bohannon goes to the line with six.
That's it. No, they can't afford to lose Geschke, because they can, worst case scenario, reverse the basketball to him against pressure, and he can bring it against one-on-one heat.
Nas with seven. Knocks that one down. He's got eight.
Nice.
Substitution. Nas is going to go take his eight to the bench. 35-33. Bees. Anthony Smothers back in to guard Teske.
Well, there they did it again, Jay.
Well,
wow.
There's a lot, you know.
What a weapon.
Speed is a big weapon, but 7-1 is not just size. It's real size. Knocked away. Shane Smith. And Jimmy Dawe comes back. And you could see the football player in him right there.
Yeah, I saw that. But I thought that Shane was held at about midcourt.
Well, I thought he might have got grabbed on the tip, but no call. Andrews back for Brooks. Chomsky out. And Sartain back. This is Jaleel Little against Luke Schaefer. Jamar Ross, Tavier Andrews. Down the left, Jaleel Little. Dahl with a rebound, gets
there
it out.
Is.
Jamar Ross had that one in his sights.
Nice.
Go.
Oh.
Davi Andrews gets it over to Jaleel Little, 15.
Yes. Ties the score, Jay.
We're tied at 35. Been a long road back. It was 29-18 at the quarter. Jackson Sartain, another one.
Oh, my.
That's 4 of 5 for him. And he has 14 points. Shane Smith, I don't think that's one that Coach Rossitano is going to be too happy with. Teske will bring it ahead.
Close.
Nice cut by Ben Geschke. Over Little. No. Smith a rebound, and Andrews will bring it ahead. Titans trail by three. Down the lane, Davi lays it up. Finger rolls
nice,
it up over
Davi. Nice.
He's having quite a half.
And, that's with 10 stitches in his hand, or eight stitches.
16 points in the half. It's been him and Sartain. Schaefer against Andrews. Right hand. A whistle, and I think that's going to be on the big fella.
I do too.
John Teske got caught rebounding from the second row. And at 38-37, Bohannon and Davis back for Lorain. Clark for Dawe for Medina. Titans with a chance to go on top. They haven't been there yet, Bob. I think it went 10-2 to start the game, 29-18 at the quarter. Lorain tied him at 35. Bohannon,
nice.
10-footer. Got it. Nas with 10. Titans up one, 39-38. And the cumulative pressure, you can see Medina starting to slow down a little bit. Now, you don't want Nas up challenging any ball handlers with two fouls. Clark. Geschke. Geschke and Davis, and Kevin gets called for the reach. Only the fourth team foul, but unfortunately, Kevin Davis has two, and Nas Bohannon has two for the Titans. Smith for Davis. Now we've got seven guys out there. Bohannon out, and Brooks in, just with the two fouls. Get them both out and play defense. Nice cut, but Andrews got back. There was the same out-of-bounds play, only they back-cut.
That's right.
When they didn't lob it, he came to the ball, and they didn't back-cut. Now he's going to throw. I was going to say they want the lob, but it's back to Schaefer. They've run that at every level.
Yeah.
Travel.
Oh, wow.
Well, it was a question of whether or not the travel happened before the bump. Coach Rossitano wanted a travel. Coach Hassinger wanted the foul. Bohannon back for Smith to play offense with a minute 16 to go. Lorain by one with the ball. This is the biggest lead of the night for the Titans, Bob. Brooks, Ross.
They're playing it.
Andrews.
Oh.
Schaefer runs through the passing lane. Puts the layup up. No, tipped up by Sartain, and he'll put the second one in. Jackson Sartain with 16 for the Bees.
Yeah, I think, Jay, does Sartain usually score like that for them?
He is a great shooter. He's very active. Yeah, I mean, he is capable of, you know, does anybody usually score 16 and a half?
No. I mean, but I was wondering if he was, you know, their number two scorer or so.
Well, their number two scorer is 22 Schaefer. In fact, he may be their number one scorer.
All right.
But he's not a shooter. He's a scorer.
Well, we're down to 22 seconds, and we're obviously playing for the last shot, and Medina is going to be content with that.
He wants Sartain to try and deny Andrews. That didn't last. They look to try and set a ball screen. Davi gets trapped. Bohannon gets it on the high post up. Tried to go up with it and gets called for a foul on the way up.
And that will be deemed on a shot.
22 Schaefer gets the foul, his first. Bohannon back to the line. He's got 10 in the game on three baskets and 4-4 at the line.
4 seconds.
You know, nice angle here as Club TV 20 providing us with, I don't know what it is, three or four different camera angles. Looking at this floor shot, now switched to the balcony shot on Nas. 40 all with 4.1 seconds to go. There's a sub at the table if Nas knocks this
down.
Watch
out. For
Smothers knocks it away with 2.3 to go off Teschke and out of bounds. Shane Smith gets pulled back, but Luke Schaefer comes back on the floor. 2.3, I would expect Davi Andrews to try to make some kind of a fake and a basket cut here. There's the back screen. Pulls up, throws.
Oh,
around the rim and no.
Tied.
Good half of basketball. Once again, we go to the locker room, all tied
wow.
up. Lorain on quarters of 18 and 22 for 40. Medina on quarters of 29 and 11 for 40. Good half of basketball, 40 apiece. Back with second half action after this timeout.
Inspiring city and campus. Inspiring people. Inspiring creativity. Inspiring hands-on learning. Inspiring global experiences. Inspiring traditions. Be a Buckeye. Inspire.
John Teschke, 33, 7'1" Michigan recruit. 22 is Luke Schaefer against Davi Andrews.
Push off.
Lob to Teschke down low against Smothers. Drop step miss. Clark had a tip, but Kevin Davis controls it. Near side Ross throws three. Nope. Bohannon with the rebound over Clark. Andrews for three. Nope. Schaefer had it poked away, but Teschke controls to Geschke. Geschke 1, Teschke 33. 22 Schaefer, 32 Clark, and 12 Sartain. Sartain has 16 to lead the Bees. Bohannon 33, Smothers 20. Davis 0, Andrews 1, and 10 Jamar Ross for the Titans. Geschke to the foul line to Teschke. We can see what they want to do early on.
They want to pound it inside to the big guy.
And you've got to make him take it to the left hand. You've got to play his left shoulder
you're
if you're stuck behind
absolutely correct.
Him.
You're absolutely correct, Jay.
I'd like to say I taught him that, but obviously I didn't. Kevin Davis for three.
Oh, big basket.
That's a big
Davis.
Shot because
that was a big basket.
A little bit impatient for the Titans, well, there, I thought.
And Davis needed to score the ball.
Yeah. First points for Kevin. lob to Teschke. He brings it against Smothers. Lots of body contact, whistle, and the foul. You know, as that developed, I just thought to myself, they're going to wait till he gets to the basket and call it. Smothers gets his first foul and the first foul of the third quarter. John Teschke goes to the line, 0-1. He's now got 8 points in the game.
Yeah, he has a nice release and rotation, too.
Medina looks, I think they're going to switch back to the zone. Teske's second one up and in. The big fella in double figures with 10. Davis against a 2-2-1 pressure. Whistle.
Say what?
I'm not sure.
What was that, Jay? One, two, three, four, five. They've got.
I was thinking it's something to do with the clock.
Okay.
6:29. It was at 6:32. Right, okay. It didn't start. Davis has it. 2-2-1 pressure. Andrews back to Davis. He'll walk it across just to slow Lorain down. Kevin Davis dips the shoulder up and under. Gets a bounce, but Teschke's all over Smothers. He smothers back to Jimmy Clark, who traveled with the basketball. You know, last year Medina won a district championship, scoring 45 points in the ball game.
Who was that against?
It was against Maslin Jackson.
Okay.
And Teschke had a triple double in that. Bohannon, Long, Jackson, Sartain with the ball.
And then who did they lose to in the regionals in the first game?
Shaker Heights, who was kryptonite to them, losing three times. Out of bounds, it'll stay with the Bees off of Bohannon. Schaefer will inbound. Ducks in against Andrews and lost the ball. Davis pushes with Geschke on him. That's going to be three on the Bees point guard. He's only got 6 points in the game, two first quarter threes, but he's the ball handler. Bohannon will inbound. Medina by one, 44-43. Kevin Davis against Jackson Sartain and Ross. This is the zone. Davis looks to penetrate and pitch. Bohannon smothers, foul shot, short. Schaefer with the board, and he gets it off to Ben Geschke. 6'1 junior walks it across against 5'10 senior Kevin Davis.
Boy, I would like to get another foul on
there's
Geschke.
The oop.
Yeah.
And
well done.
Teschke with the catch and the easy lay-in. He's got 12, 6 in the quarter, and the Bees are up three. And again, the pace is to Medina's liking, as the Bees have been unable to score the ball. The only points of the quarter on a three-pointer. Andrews was very effective slicing through, but Teschke controlled the rebound, and Jackson Sartain down the middle. Jimmy Clark laid it up.
Oh, not a good angle. He still dropped it in.
Six for Clark, and the lead is back to five. Remember, it was 11 at the end of the first quarter, and Lorain spent the whole second quarter battling back.
Big basket.
Jamar Ross throws three. Whistle, timeout.
Both Davis and Ross have come up with a big three in this quarter.
That's big. Coach Rossitano takes a 20-second timeout.
Oh, Jay, can I have a minute?
Yes.
Because I have all the names. You know, we've got a great broadcast tonight with camera angles, and we're showing the score on the scoreboard, all the good stuff. And that's all due to Joe Bach's Channel 20 crew, which is a class here at Lorain High. And I want to mention Joe's main man, Terry Trout, too. But student-wise tonight, we've got Brianna Nethers, Autumn Sexton, Alexis Sexton, Daniel Lopez, Alexis Alicia, and Jaden Morales are all helping. They're running cameras. They're running switchers. They're on a computer. They're doing all the tough stuff.
They've classed up everything but us, Bob.
There you go.
Schaefer will inbound for Medina. They're up two at 48-46. 4:43 to go, third quarter. That's Jimmy Daw and Colin Tumsky, sophomore backup point guard, brings it ahead against Davis.
Nice.
Good ball pressure. Schaefer against Davi Andrews. Got to take Schaefer's right hand away.
Let's see how they play without Geschke.
laid that one up and in. That's what Luke Schaefer does. He's very effective getting to the hoop. Second leading scorer for the Bees on the year. Davis to Bohannon. Nas has got the big fella on him. 10-footer over him. Changed the arc, and the rebound is off to Jim Daw. Daw gets it ahead with a long outlet to Schaefer. Back to Chomsky. And they'll set up the offense. Jaleel Little 12 and Deshaun Brooks 5 into the ballgame. Schaefer runs it down at half court and gets it over to Daw. Got Brooks on Sartain. Daw with the layup.
Too easy.
Yep. Davis, near corner Brooks. Little penetrates with the left, throws it up. Got it partially deflected, I think. Sartain away with it. Schaefer on a run out, pulls up from 18, round the rim, no, and Jaleel Little's got a board. Andrews comes back into the lane, kicks it out. Davis is going to throw one. Got
yes!
it.
Yes!
KD with 6 in the quarter and in the game. Big shot, 52-49 Medina. He started to feel that the tempo was in their favor, but the Titans got running a little bit.
Well, I thought, you know, tempo forced them to wear down a little bit in the first half.
Totally agree. Here's the delay as they get it down, isolating Schaefer off the rim, no, and Little's got another one and pushes ahead to Davis. Davis with Chomsky is going to go to the line.
Okay.
Colin Chomsky, 5'10 sophomore, first foul. Kevin Davis, 5'10 senior, point guard to the line for two throws. What's he from the line?
I'm checking right now, 36 of 47, Jay, for...
A little over 75%.
Over, yeah, that's great.
Give him another one. Substitution, Jim Clark, Ben Geschke back in for Medina. Schaefer to the bench along with Clark.
76.6%, Jay, which is very, very good in high school.
Second one up. And he was money against Warrensville, if you'll recall. Daw lost it and picked it up and traveled with it. I'm sure that Coach Hassinger is saying to Jim Daw what Coach Rossitano would be saying to one of his big, know your role. And get the rebound and pass it to a guard. Jaleel Little up top with Davi Andrews. Bohannon a ball screen. And Davi pulled it and Bohannon's trapped. Gets it across to Brooks. Brooks down the lane, slices in, underhand up. And Teske comes back for the rebound, gets it ahead. Geschke's going to have a layup over Bohannon, and Geschke rebounded it out of bounds.
That's right.
Nas Bohannon totally affected that shot, didn't he?
Well, and Nas made a great pass out of that trap down
there.
Yes,
he did. Andrews, Brooks, Andrews. Brooks has got to look at the basket.
He
Shane Smith
does.
In at the foul line. Shane
reverse
Smith.
It, reverse it.
There, oh, there it was.
Oh, there he was.
He didn't cut for the ball.
Ooh.
And Daw stepped in front of Smith. 52-50, Bees by two with the ball. 2 minutes to go, third quarter. Geschke handles now against Andrews. Good matchup. Chomsky and Little. Smith runs through the passing lane and knocks it out away from Daw. That brings Sartain back into the ball game. Let's see how that affects the matchups. He had 16 in the first half. Kevin Davis back for Andrews. Get a blow here last minute 46 of the third quarter. Brooks has Sartain lobbed.
Yeah, there's that same play.
Didn't get enough air under it, and Teske has to run it down and bring it out.
They clear out the backside and lob.
Jackson Sartain with Deshaun Brooks. There's the little triangle delay game that Medina ran. They ran it to a couple of layups in the first half. Now, Geschke handles against Little. Jaleel steps in and the count goes back on. That's Sartain and that's Jimmy Daw lobbing for John Teske. He got whacked in the act.
Okay.
Five, Deshaun Brooks, 6'4 junior with the foul, his first.
That was well orchestrated there. What, you know, what Teske did, Jay, was he stepped through as the ball was reversed and got the defense at his back.
Big John off the front of the rim. When he gets tired, he has a tendency to get flat-footed like he did there, not use the legs. Brooks out, Little out. Andrews back, and Smothers back. 52-50. Bees by three, a minute 16 in the third. Second one on its way, again front rims it.
Okay, I'll take it.
Kevin Davis, as the big fella, Kryptonite might be the line. He's up, but there's Daw running through, but Davis getting it back. Andrews.
Nice jump stop. Oh, yeah.
Bohannon with the tip. Nas with 13, first points of the half, and we're tied at 52. Daw against pressured inbound to Geschke. Trap gets rid of it and gets it across to Chomsky.
Back
Davis
pressure.
With the back pressure. Chomsky pulls it out and gets it to Ben Geschke with 45 seconds to go. Tied at 52. We were tied at 40 at the half. Now that's Teske at the elbow. Sartain, three ball.
Good. Dang it.
5 of 5 behind the line.
Yeah.
For Jackson Sartain, who was shooting about 75% from there coming into the game. Kevin Davis had it down. Smothers put it back.
21 seconds.
Bees by one. Teske, Smothers, challenging him. Lots of contact both ways. Lots of contact on that one. Smothers is going to get his second, both in this half.
Boy, I thought that could have gone the other way.
I thought it could have gone either way.
Wow.
It's hard to say because it all depends on which contact they called a foul on.
Yes.
They were doing some leaning. Now Teske will get a break.
14 seconds remaining in the quarter.
14 seconds to go, and Medina up one. Jackson Sartain to inbound to Ben Geschke against Shane Smith. Now Kevin Davis picks him up at half court, under 10. They're Little. Teske is on the bench here. Jackson Sartain behind a handoff.
No,
it.
Come on, Jay. Oh, he's at the buzzer.
Jackson Sartain has 6 out of 6 from behind the line tonight, Bob. 22 points, and we've played three. Medina 58, Lorain 54. Back with more after this timeout.
I started mentoring my mentee, Dontre, 4 years ago. I always thought about doing it. It always seemed like a good idea.
We were both nervous when we first met, but everything kind of fell into place.
Mentoring is important to anyone that's pretty fortunate in life to have a little bit of time to pass on that knowledge.
Etienne's a very close friend. I look at him as a brother and a father figure. He taught me just focus on the big picture because I would like to give back just like Etienne gave back to me. Be someone who matters to someone who matters.
Back here at Lorain, fourth quarter. Kevin Davis handles for the Titans, 58-54 Medina. Davi Andrews, number one, 20 is Anthony Smothers. 10 is Jamar Ross. Davis down the lane, throws one up off the glass. And Ben Geschke comes away for Medina. Also on the court for Lorain is Nas Bohannon, number 33. Geschke, number one. Sartain, 12 with the 6 threes. Colin Chomsky, number 20. Secondary ball handler. Whistle, and that's going to be on 32, Jim Clark on the illegal screen. That was a heat check play. Did you see what that was?
Yeah, I saw what that was.
Jackson Sartain, 6 of 6 from the line,
right
behind the arc.
And he was going, definitely, it was a
looking
heat
for
check.
A little fade. Davis walks it up. Andrews, Ross, down low to Smothers, knocked away by Schaefer, back to Anfernee. Fumbled
that's
it, laid it up and in.
That's it.
8 for Anfernee. Got to make hay inside when the big fella's on the bench. Geschke has it over to Clark, back to Luke Schaefer. Schaefer brings it against Smothers.
Oh.
And that's what he does well. That's 3 on Anfernee. Luke Schaefer, as I said to you earlier in the game, he's not a shooter, he's a scorer. And he can get to the hoop and draw contact.
6'3 junior, Jay. In fact, their entire, you know, perimeter crew is our underclassmen.
Knocked that one down. The only seniors that play significant minutes are Clark, 32, and, of course, 7-1,
right.
John Teske.
I mean, they've got it coming. If you take a look at that size down of the JV team with these,
right,
you know, with what we see here, they're in good shape.
Luke Schaefer knocks down a pair. He's got 6, and the lead is 4. It was tied at the half. Medina led by 4 at the quarter, and that's where it is now. Knocked away from behind from Bohannon, but out of bounds. Good alert play by Schaefer there.
Yeah.
And Teske remains on the bench. 7 minutes to go, fourth quarter.
I thought based upon those last two free throws you took, Jay, he was gassed.
Yeah. Hit the front of the rim short on both. Andrews, look, just play give and go with Bohannon. Bohannon into the lane. One-hander, No. Rebound by Sartain.
They're formidable without him on the floor.
Yeah, well, and Sartain is really active on the glass.
Yeah.
Is that 140 pounds that he weighs, is he goes and gets it. Clark against Smothers.
They're playing that little delay game of theirs.
Geschke, yeah. Well, they play it to score.
Well, they're going to back cut you out of that. They've taken help away from around the basket. The other two guys are out wide.
Geschke now with Davis, and they set up a called play here. Geschke to Sartain, back to Geschke. Clark goes up to the double high post now. He takes it. There's the scissors cut. Jackson Sartain picks up the dribble with Smothers in his face. Down
wow,
low,
good
Geschke.
Steal.
Geschke found Clark, and there's a whistle and a foul, and it's not a bad foul.
No, that was a good seal.
Bohannon gets the foul, his third. And Clark will go to the line for two, but he had a chippy if there wasn't a foul because he used his body well.
Again, well designed.
Jimmy Clark, 6'3 senior. Around and no. Day-Day Brooks in for Smothers. You want Smothers to get a rest as long as Teske is on the bench, I would guess. Now John is back, but Anfernee is out. Daw is at the table for Clark if he makes. Medina may set up that 2-2-1 to slow Lorain down. Back rim and Bohannon.
Dodged the bullet there.
Andrews, Lorain needs a hoop. Davis gets it across. Jamar Ross. Davi Andrews has been contained in the second half. Basket
tip
up,
it.
No, tips it up,
yes.
Up and in. 16 in the first half, first hoop of the second half. He's got 18. To lead the Titans, Geschke against Davis, 60-58. Dribble handoff. Far side, they look for the big fella. Didn't stay patient. Schaefer, Clark. Clark looks to go high-low. Oh, good spin there.
Yeah,
into
the
lane. Teske one-on-one with Nas. Yeah. Lays it up with the right.
Yeah.
Just not a whole lot you can do other than maybe
really
make him
isn't.
Go the other way. He's got 14 now. Jamar Ross, Kevin Davis, Andrews. Wouldn't be a bad to go after Geschke with the three
no,
fouls.
No, it wouldn't.
Kevin Davis gets to the rim, but Teske affected him without touching it. Chomsky gets it over to Geschke, and they come ahead up four. 4:49 to go, fourth quarter. Teske throws
Teske
three.
With a three?
Short.
Nice pass.
And then he gets the assist to Chomsky.
Wow.
Whistle, timeout, Lorain. Coach Rossitano frustrated there that the big fella was able to run down his own miss.
You know, we're really struggling scoring the ball, Jay, because
but
you know what, you know, they do well. They recover defensively. We're not getting anything in transition. Obviously, we're not getting much off the full court pressure. I mean, they make you go through, like we talk about all the time, through the heart of their defense.
And at the back of that heart stands 7-1.
Yeah, exactly. So, I mean, you could do everything right, get it inside, and as on Davis's last attack to the basket, he doesn't have to touch the ball. He just has to be there.
Yeah, if you're looking for
it. And force you to change your shot. I mean, it's I'm very impressed. But they're good with him when he's on the bench, too. I'm especially impressed with Geschke.
Handles
the point
the ball
guard.
Real
he
well.
Handles it well. He makes the first open man, gets the ball, doesn't turn it over, doesn't force anything. He's a key.
Been a varsity player since his freshman year.
I can see why.
And as I said, his brother before him, second team All-Ohio his senior year, averaged about 24 a game. And he was really a shooter.
And that was at Medina also?
Yes. He started on the regional final team.
Okay.
4 years ago, 4.5 years ago now. Andrews against Geschke gets a screen from Bohannon, penetrates. And Teske just followed him down the lane and pinned it. Chomsky handling the ball a little bit more in the fourth quarter as they put two ball handlers in. J. Jimmy Dawe, but down the lane, Luke Schaefer laid it up and in.
Ouch.
He's going to come back to the right hand 100% of the time. Lead is 8, biggest since the first quarter.
Big basket
Brooks
there.
Gets it, 3 of them back with that one. Day-Day with 8. There's the release of pressure back to Schaefer. Make him handle the ball. That's not who they want dribbling it. And that's why. Andrews gets a piece and gets an assist from Brooks.
Jay, if you could deny Geschke, they struggle.
Well, and that's
Shane
the first
Smith's
part
on him
of it.
Right now.
That's the first part of it. Oh, he's going to say that Ross got under that.
Wow.
Sartain back quickly for Chomsky. Secondary ball handling, I'm thinking.
Wow, I'm almost thinking, Jay, deny Geschke the basketball in every situation.
What about the guy with 6 threes? You just put him back in the game. Schaefer looks for the lob, throws
good
it up.
Good anticipation.
Andrews distracted, and Teske tried to go rather than catch it. Oh, he double dribbled. Well,
Schaefer was going to run through the passing lane, and Nas picked up his dribble and saw it.
Coach Ross goes with one big on the floor. Now Smith comes back for Little, and the Titans with Nas. This is the lineup that brought him back against North Olmsted in the fourth quarter. 66-63, Medina with ball and lead. Ross and Geschke. Teske relieves pressure. Geschke in the corner is Sartain, and Davi Andrews trying to deny him. Geschke spins, 17-footer on the way.
Oh, no.
The bank is open late on Tuesday.
No.
Geschke with a prayer, and they're up 5. Ross throws 3, got it. Big shot, Jamar with 6. 68-66, he's had 2 big ones this quarter. They tried to take a run at Geschke, and he wisely backed away. Walks it across. It had to be close. Jimmy Dawe, and they look for Teske, who catches and lays it in. His footwork is so much better.
Yeah, and that's by design, Jay. They clear out to help, and if you front him, they throw over top.
Yes. He's got 16. Geschke, Andrews traveled. 70-66. Medina with ball and lead. 2:32 to go. Dawe to inbound. Geschke gets it against Ross. Make him work and make him pass. Geschke down the lane all the way with the right hand. No. Chomsky got a piece of that and knocked it out of bounds. They just went to a possession with Teske at half court. Chomsky's going to come out. Dawe back in. Now Medina goes a little bit bigger to counter Lorraine's small lineup. A chess match going on. 70-66 B's, but Davis has got it. Fakes the 3. Ross on Sartain. Andrews and Davis. Ball screen and slip. Davis with the left gets bumped, and I think that's going to be 4. Only the 4th foul on Medina, but it's also the 4th foul on Ben Geschke.
Okay, that's a good thing.
Now, 2:05 to go. Here comes Chomsky, but he didn't make it. They guard the out-of-bounds with the 7-footer.
Attack him, Davier.
I don't think they realized. Davis with Teske on him. Rocker step. You just don't realize how long he is. He may be 8 feet away, but his arms aren't. Kevin Davis launches short. Teske boxes out, but Bohannon corrals. Nas up top. Ross.
Go ahead.
Skip Davis. Dawe closed out well. Davis in trouble, gets in the corner. Shane Smith launches. A knuckleball 3.
Timeout.
Lorain, 70-69. B's up 1. Big shot for Shane.
Jay, we have had some big threes fall in the second half.
Both teams. Lorain with 6 threes in the half. You got 2 from Davis, 2 from Ross. Brooks has 1 and Smith has 1. And
huge.
For Medina, Sartain's got 2 in the half, 6 of 6 for the ball game.
Yeah.
Which is
wow.
Crazy shooting.
Yeah, that is. But Jay, you showed me his stats for the year. He's like 75% or in his last 25, he's 75% made.
Well, he gets a lot of good looks, obviously. He does a couple things really well. He spaces the floor well in transition,
yep,
and gets looks there. And then a lot of teams like to double off, you know, off right, the perimeter on the big kid.
Yep.
And, you know, Jackson Sartain has been the recipient of good looks. And that's only part of it. You got to make them. And his dad told me at halftime, before the last game, he was about 75%. And he's 6-6 tonight.
Yeah.
So depending on what his stats were against Elyria, he may be up close to 80%. Luke Schaefer will inbound for the Bees. Sartain runs out, cross screen, and they throw it to the big. Why wouldn't you?
Relief
pressure. Teske trapped, throws it away.
There it is.
Andrews picks it up. Over to Shane Smith. Come down on in the corner, Jamar Ross launches.
Oh!
Around the rim.
Yes!
Andrews and foul.
Davier! Wow!
No foul, huh?
No foul and another steal by Andrews.
Steal by Andrews. Lorain by one, a minute 10 to go. Now the foul situation is against Medina.
Wow.
They only have four. Whistled Sartain with the foul.
Okay.
His first.
Their fifth. Not going to the line yet.
I think you got to bring Brooks for Smith.
Well, we got. I would agree with you, Jay, there. You want free throw shooters on the floor.
And Jimmy Daw in for Medina for Schaefer. A little bit more size and a little bit
wow,
of more athleticism. Oh, not for Schaefer, excuse me. Into the back, that was for Geschke with the four fouls.
101 left.
There's foul
the
given by Schaefer. Or that's Daw, excuse me. His second, 16 foul, 59.8 to go. Lorain will inbound in front of the scorer's table.
Wow.
Andrews with Colin Chomsky and over to Kevin Davis and Luke Schaefer.
I was going to say,
that's a matchup
to the
in Lorain's favor.
I don't mind that.
And KD goes to the line.
Again.
One of two on the evening. What's he from?
As we said earlier, he's 76.6% from the line for the year.
Shane Smith will come back for defense for Brooks. Daw out, Geschke in for offense for the Beast. Whistle, full timeout by Chris Hassinger of the Medina Beast.
Jay, I'm surprised at two things. I'm surprised when they were given their fouls, they didn't do it going for the basketball. And number two, that last foul on Davis, I mean, it almost looked like that's what they wanted to do.
Yeah, it didn't.
Which doesn't make a whole lot of sense to me.
Well, I mean, if you were going to foul one of the players on the floor.
Well, I don't know if I'd foul anybody at this point.
I don't, I was going to say, I don't think it would be KD.
Yeah, and it certainly wouldn't be Kevin Davis, 76% shooter. But, Jay, I mean, Lorain High has made a couple of real plays here to get back yep, into this lead. I mean.
Bobby Andrews with a big tip in and then a big steal.
Yeah, and then the big steal. And go back to what our good friend Kevin Mackey talks about with pressure. You know, eventually he'll.
Pressure busts pipes.
Yep. Wow.
And Coach Rossitano said to me before the game, if we don't speed them up, we're in trouble. And both in the second quarter and the fourth quarter,
right,
they have
exactly
been able to speed
exactly
them up.
Exactly, and it's happened toward the ends of the quarter, which means, you know, fatigue.
Yep. And it's not just physical fatigue.
Oh, Jay, you're absolutely right. It's not physical fatigue.
KD at the line, 7 in the ball game, 1-2. First
yes
shot. And he'll get the bonus.
Jay, I mean, if
this is a big one,
if
right
Kevin
here
makes this one, we're coming down in defense of the three-point line. We've got to.
Well, it's 53 seconds. I don't think you have to take a three. Second one on its way.
Oh, yes. Good job.
Davis has 9. All
there it is.
Whistle.
Yes.
There's a throwaway.
Pressure. Sub.
Who threw the ball in, Bob?
I didn't see who threw it in, but Brooks is coming in for
Shane Smith. Bohannon will inbound. Daw in for Geschke because of the four fouls. They want him for offense get it back. Davis in the backcourt with Colin Chomsky on
it. Kevin Davis with the basketball.
You've got to get him across the line. Now he penetrates and kicks back to Davi Andrews, who gets it over to Naz Bohannon.
Strong cuts.
like that. Everybody cut to the same spot, however. Now they got to bounce the floor. Jackson Sartain gives a foul. 34.8 to go.
Well, I wish we were double bonus, Jay. Well, but we're not. That's their eighth.
Smith back for Lorain. Geschke back for Medina. KD back to the line. He just hit two. 3 of 4 on the night. That was short.
Ouch.
Rebound by Sartain for the Bees. He's going to have to bring it against Smith. Picks it up, throws it off to Geschke. They're going to have to hurry.
Come on, come on.
26 seconds. They get it across. 24 seconds. Medina needs three. Lorain has two fouls to give.
Got a defensive three-point line or give a foul.
Schaefer throws it down low. That's whistle. Oh, my goodness.
What was the call, Jay?
They called a push-off on
Teske?
The big fella, yeah.
Oh, my. Well, he was positioned to get the two, the easy two, and that wasn't going to beat us. Free throw shooter, catch the ball, Kevin Davis, make a cut. Set
Coach
a pick
Hassinger
for him.
Just upset, like, why now? Andrews, Bohannon, Andrews. Chomsky fouls him with 10.6.
That's their ninth foul.
Well, they won't get a chance at number 10 unless something weird happens.
Coach Roz has got two timeouts left. I mean, you hate to isolate your own player, but I mean,
he's got two fouls left.
What do you mean, two fouls?
Lorain only has five fouls.
No, right, right.
I mean, we have a foul to give.
And that's something that could be talked about. That's a good timeout for us taken by Medina, by the way, because, I mean, you've got to set some things up here. We've got two fouls to give, as you pointed out. And then in case of a miss here, you want to make sure you defense a three-point line.
We'll give him a two. Coach Gillum's telling him that right now as I just saw him look up at the scoreboard.
I mean, that was a great timeout Medina took for us.
And we couldn't take it because we're down to one. So you didn't want to waste one and not be able to get the ball in.
I got you. You're right.
Yeah.
I thought we had two. You're right, Jay.
So 73-70. Davier Andrews, what's he from the line?
Davier is 54.
Oh.
54. I would have thought Davier would be a little bit higher than that. For the year, he's 54%, and he's been fouled quite well, not really as much as I thought either. 13 for 24.
Yeah, that's not a big sample size. We take 50% right here because if he gets the first one, it's a two-possession ball game.
Oh, I would love the first one.
And then I'd almost like him to miss the second one and make him outlet it and bring it up. Yeah.
Their 10th foul, double bonus. I thought it was nine.
Oh, it is a double bonus. Okay.
They've got 10 up there now.
Well.
They had nine for a second. I thought it was nine.
They've got the two arrows. It was nine at the timeout, Bob.
All right. Okay, double bonus here. Let's
you know what?
One.
The ninth foul was the push-off on Teske.
That's right. That's right.
Andrews at the line, 22 in the game. 23 makes it a four-point lead.
Okay.
74-70. I might pull the guys off the lane. You don't want to foul here if you're Coach Rossitano. Trusting Bohannon and Smith.
All right.
Second one in. Davi's got 24. The lead is 5. Geschke brings it ahead under 10. Geschke
Six seconds.
Way to the lane. Lays it up with the left. Timeout Medina with 4. Geschke has 10. 75-72.
Well, fortunately, we have that one timeout that you talked about, Jay, in case we can't get it inbounds. That's key. And then, of course, you want to inbound the basketball to a free throw shooter because you're going to get fouled immediately. Davier looked pretty good at the line on the last those last two, and so does Kevin Davis. They are out of timeouts, and we have one remaining.
Well, one of the things that I really like, and it's a Mike Krzyzewski thought, is, you know, when you got to inbound the ball, he says put your smartest player out of bounds. And for the Titans, that's 33 Naz Bohannon, and he's the guy that is the trigger.
Well,
so, yeah, you got to trust him
also
to make a good decision.
The last thing you say to him is, if it's not there for sure, take our last time out.
Yeah, you're taking calculus, so you can count to 5.
There
so when you get to 4, yell time out.
Absolutely. This is key. Come on, fellas.
Okay, now the clock's got to tick down. The timeout's got a couple seconds left in it. I hate it on the scoreboard like that. 5.0.
Okay.
Put a second back on. 75-72, Teske will guard Bohannon. He throws it long for Andrews. Andrews is fouled.
Wow.
4.9 off the clock as Chomsky grabs on his third foul. That's about as quick as you can be. So we'll go to the line with Davi Andrews. 24. And again, now one will do it. Medina's out of timeouts.
You need one of these.
One of these.
If they score, you don't
down.
Even have to take it inbound the ball.
You don't want to, yeah.
In fact, I'm sure everybody's aware of that.
There's right. one.
You can let them score, and it's over. It's impossible. You don't have
Brooks
to inbound the basketball.
Out Smith in, and now Coach Rossitano is going to tell them that. 4.1, 76-72. Boy, has this been a good one.
This has been terrific. I'm so glad. You know, we're coming off a couple of tough ones last week, and this is to beat a quality team. Medina's a quality yeah. team.
As we said, both teams were regional qualifiers a year ago. They played a six-point game at Medina last year, which for the longest time was the closest game Lorain had played.
Yeah, right.
But it wasn't that close. I mean, Medina closed at the end. This one has been back and forth yeah. and back and forth the whole way. And Lorain started down four in the fourth quarter. But it's been 22-14 Titans
wow.
in the fourth.
Boy, Davier has made a couple of plays. And, you know, Kevin shot the ball well, made a couple key
yeah.
free throws. And, you know, Ross hit a three. I mean, players have made plays.
Ross had two big second yeah. half threes. Brooks had a big three.
Yeah.
Andrews with the second of two. Coach Rossitano has his guys at the half court and back. Davi with 26.
Can let them score and take it out of bounds and don't throw
Ross
it
Ross takes a run at Geschke, who drives to the hoop, lays it up, and scores
wow.
at the buzzer.
Yes!
What a game! Titans oh. 77, Medina 74. We'll be back after this timeout to wrap this one up.
Stop. Whether it's on the way to school, at school, or online, bullying has become a nonstop threat to our youth today. Is your child being bullied? The National Runaway Switchboard can help. If you're having a hard time, get online or call to chat now.
Back here at Lorain High, Bob, the makings of a classic.
Yep, it was.
The boxer versus the puncher. quickness versus size
yeah.
in basketball, and that's what happened tonight. Mm. And pressure is cumulative, as the advocates will tell you. And Lorain, listen to these second and fourth quarters. Medina takes the first, 29-18. 22-11 Lorain in the second to tie it at 40 at the half.
Yeah.
Medina wins the third, 18-14, to take a 58-54 lead. And in the fourth quarter, 23 for the Titans, 16 for the Bees, to give them a 77-74 win. So the Titans outscored Medina 45-27 in the second and fourth quarters. The cumulative effect of the pressure.
You're absolutely right, Jay. There's no question about it.
And a lot of great individual performances
yes.
here
players
tonight.
Made plays.
And, you know, for Medina, who falls to 11-4 on the year, Ben Geschke had 6 points on five baskets. Two of them were threes. Jackson Sartain, 6 of 6 behind the line as part of his 22 points. Colin Chomsky had 3 baskets for 6. Luke Schaefer, 3 baskets and 2 of 2 at the line for 8. Jimmy Daw, basket in each half, 4. And Jimmy Clark had 3 baskets, 0 of 2 at the line for 6. And the big fella, John Teske, had 7 baskets, 2 of 5 at the line for 16. Altogether, it adds up to 74. For the Titans, Naz Bohannon had 11 in the first half, but only a basket in the second half for 13. Ask him and he'll tell you he doesn't care. Anthony Smothers, 2 baskets in each half for 8. Jaleel Little had a couple of baskets in the first half for 4. Jamar Ross, 2 big 3s coming down the stretch for 6. Deshaun Brooks had a 3 in each half, and it was a big one in
yeah.
the second half, and 2 of 2 at the line, 8. Shane Smith, the knuckleball 3 from the corner to bring the Titans within 1 down the stretch, his only basket of the night. Kevin Davis, 2 threes and 3 of 5 from the line in the second half, 9 points altogether. And the big guy in the ball game, Davier yeah. Andrews, had 4 of 4 at the line He had two threes. Everything else was a two. 26 points on the night to lead both teams in scoring. Yeah. But, Bob, it was the Titans' pressure defense versus the size inside of Medina. And Lorain was able to speed them up in both second and fourth quarter and come away with a win.
Right. Jay, if I'm not mistaken, weren't we down by six with about 2 minutes left?
Yes.
A little less than 2 minutes. And you're absolutely right about the pressure. Eventually.
I think it was 72-66.
Yes. I think that's what it was.
And outscored them 11-2.
Right. Exactly. And it was the cumulative effect. But what I was so glad to see was players, you know, Ross came up big, Davis came up big. You know, Davier was terrific. I mean, in the first half, slicing to the basket. Second half, couple key stick backs and, you know, steals. And but just collectively as a group, how they competed. I mean, they really had to compete, and they did so against a quality team. That Medina team is good. And then I thought, you know, my hat's off to Coach Gillum and Coach Roz. I thought they coached an excellent game, used the timeouts as we talked about during the game, and you know, did everything worked that they called. I mean, it was just well done. Nice coaching job.
Did a good job defensively inside as Teschke had 16, but they held him down for the most part. And a big win for the Titans, and the road goes on. And we talked about 11 days ago, we said the Titans were undefeated and untested, but the next five games would prove, you know, quality opposition. They came out 3-2 on the year and now move to 10-2 on the season. Medina drops to 11-4. It's a non-conference tilt to both. And, you know, as you start thinking about tournament time, these are the kind of games that get you ready.
Yeah, no question about it. I mean, this was just, and I know our viewers are pretty sharp. They know what they saw tonight. This was two quality teams. Both played well. Both played very well.
Titans will be back on the hardwood Friday. I'm not sure against who.
That's against Cleveland Heights, I believe.
It's against Cleveland Heights. It's at Lutheran East.
Right.
So if you're planning on going, get there early. The gym seats less than 600.
Right.
And then the Cleveland Heights gym is under construction.
And then at home the following Tuesday, North Ridgeville.
So be here for that one. But for my buddy Bob Braskich, for Joe Bach, for Terry Trout, for Club TV 20, we thank you guys very much for getting us on the air and giving us all the things that make it special. This is Jay Ferguson, though. Have a good night, everybody.
This has been a production of Lorain City Schools TV 20 WLCS.
To purchase a high-quality copy of the program you just viewed, please call Lorain City Schools Television at 282-8400.